Now we will study about the contraceptive pills for men.
Contraceptive pill for men. The contraceptive pill for the man, first of all, developed by the China. The China has developed first contraceptive pill in July 2000. That is the they have developed the Gosipol. It is developed from the cotton seed. It is the first contraceptive pill for male or the man, but it has been banned. It is banned because it causes the azoospermia. That is, it prevents the spermatogenesis. It prevents spermatogenesis. So it has been banned. Now the next pill is the DMAU. That is dimethylandrolone undecanoate. This is a daily contraceptive pill, and it is actually a synthetic progesterone. Synthetic progestogen. This progestogen, this DMAU, causes the lowering of FSH and LH in males. Means follicle stimulating hormone and the luteinizing hormone are lower down. Due to this, it causes the decrease in the production of the sperm and androgen, means testosterone development secretion is decreases. Both the sperm and androgen formation and the release is decreases. So it prevents the, means it has the impact on lowering the chances of the fertilization. But it is under the process of trial and the development. So the contraceptive pill is actually not very common, because the barrier and the other methods for the contraception for men are available. Now we will study about the emergency contraception. Emergency contraception. So for emergency contraception, the pills are there. That is the I pill or the emergency contraceptive pill or morning after pill. They are called as the morning after pill. For the emergency contraception. So what are the causes for the failure of the contraception? So it can be, means causes of failure of contraception. So it may be the missing of pill, rupture of barrier, means then it could be the failure of any intrauterine devices. That may lead to the development of the undesirable pregnancy, and it could be forceful insemination. It may be the cases of sexual assault, sexual abuse. And so that we have studied the natural method of the contraception that may fails. So failure of means coitus interrupts or penis withdrawal. Actually, the survival period of the sperm of the male gamete into the female reproductive tract, it is the 120 hours, means 5 days. 5 days or 120 hours. It is the, for this time, the sperm can survive in female reproductive tract. So during the insemination, during the forceful insemination, or during the cases of this, the sperm is definitely transferred into the female reproductive tract, but the ovulation may or may not be sure. So it is not sure whether the ovulation has taken place or not. So in that case, the eye pill or the morning after pill or the emergency contraceptive pill are taken within this 120 hours, but it is suggested to be taken within the 72 hours, means 3 days, 72 hours or 3 days after the coitus. So this should be taken within this duration after the coitus to prevent the development of the undesirable pregnancy. This eye pill or the morning after pill, it inhibit, it prevent or delay, it prevents or delay the ovulation. It prevents or delay ovulation. So the chances of the fertilization are decreases. But this eye pill or the morning after pill do not abort the termination of pregnancy. It do not causes the abortion. And this eye pill or morning after pill has the levonorgestrel. It is similar to the desogestrel, that is the synthetic progesterone. So it is the synthetic progesterone, that is progestin. Levonorgestrel, that is the synthetic progesterone, progestin. So it prevents or delay the ovulation. It is important that it has to be taken within the 3 days after the coitus. So this point is to be important for the NEET. So that within how much duration the emergency contraceptive pill should be taken after the unprotected coitus. So these are the emergency contraception cases. Now there are some side effects of the contraceptive pills. So the vitamin E deficiency also causes the contraception. So it leads to the fertility. Vitamin E deficiency, it actually decreases the FSH and LH level into the body. So it will prevent the ovulation, or it will delay the ovulation. So ovulation is prevented or delayed, so fertilization will not take place. It may also lead to the infertility or sterility. Infertility, impotency and sterility. So vitamin E deficiency actually lowers down the FSH and LH. It actually increases the progesterone and the estrogen level. By increasing the progesterone and estrogen level, it increases the progesterone and estrogen level. So the follicle stimulating hormone and the luteinizing hormone are decreases. This is the outcome of the vitamin E deficiency. So it is also termed as the anti-sterility vitamin. Now there are the some side effects of the contraceptive pill. Side effects of contraceptive pill. There are nausea,
means urge to vomit. It is abnormalities in menstruation, menstrual abnormalities. It leads to the obesity. These are actually the symptoms of the steroidal contraceptive pills, as these are not associated with the non-steroidal contraceptive pills that we have studied into the Centrobroman or the Saheli. Then it also causes the degeneration of vitamin D and the prolonged use of this contraceptive pill even may leads to the impotency or infertility. Impotency, that is the non-erection of the penis, impotency or the infertility. So this is all about the contraceptive pills for the man and the their side effects and the emergency contraception. So this is to be remembered ultimately. Now we will study about the injections and the implants methods of the hormonal contraception.